Hey everybody, welcome back to the Thinking Crypto channel, your home for cryptocurrency news and interviews. Today we're going to talk about Mr. Wonderful, Kevin O'Leary. We went on a show today and talked about what's in his crypto portfolio, specifically which altcoins he's invested in, and what's his strategy moving forward. We also have news of a Fidelity alumni that is about to launch a crypto fund. It seems like everybody's launching a crypto fund these days. We also have some bullish crypto regulation news out of India, and crypto.com, the respective exchange and platform, had a big issue today that I want to let you guys know about if you use that platform. And we're seeing a spike in crypto jobs on LinkedIn. The industry, we're seeing just a plethora of different open positions, and it could be a great opportunity for some of you who would like to work in the industry. So we're going to break it all down. Before we get to it, please go ahead and hit the thumbs up button, leave a comment below, and hit the subscribe button if you're new here. It helps support the channel and it doesn't cost you anything. Guys, earlier today, I uploaded my interview with Mance Harmon, the co-founder and CEO of Hedera Hashgraph, HBAR, which I hold in my portfolio. I'm certainly bullish on it. Be sure to check out that interview. I'll put a link in the description. And this video is brought to you by Algorand, which is building the future of finance. Algorand is one of the leading blockchain projects in the crypto industry. I personally hold the Algo token in my portfolio. We have NFTs, CBDCs being built on Algorand. You have both Anthony Scaramucci and Michael Arrington's respective hedge funds investing in Algorand. And if you would like to learn more about Algorand, please visit Algorand.com. If we take a look at the crypto market here, Bitcoin had a pullback, a small pullback, and as a result, the rest of the altcoins pullbacked as well. You know, I've talked about this for so long, guys, about the altcoins follow Bitcoin's move the majority of the time. So we want Bitcoin to do well, more capital to flow through Bitcoin, excuse me, and then flow into the altcoins. That's how it's played out historically. And it's not that I want it to be that way, but rather that's what the facts and the data tells us, guys. So right now, Bitcoin at 42K. If we look at the weekly chart here, which we've been monitoring for a long time, we see a weak red candle being formed on the weekly chart. Now that could easily flip. Right, we've seen that, but we'll have to see how this week plays out. Like I said in yesterday's video, this thing could get choppy. It can move sideways and be very volatile until Bitcoin really finds that support at 40K and then bounces upwards. And hopefully we see a run to new all-time highs and then eventually have an alt season. So we'll have to wait and see how things play out. Now, in yesterday's video, I talked about the Bitcoin Mining Council webinar that's going to take place tomorrow. And this is significant. We can get some very bullish news along the lines of Elon Musk and Tesla. So I will be keeping an eye out on that. I'm sure many of you will as well. And I'll have an updated video for you and, of course, a podcast tomorrow on that news. Now, macro level, I want to share what Benjamin Cohen of Into the Cryptoverse put together. Showing here the crypto market cap, the total crypto market cap and the timeline. Here's what he had to say. A picture is worth a thousand words, hashtag Bitcoin. Note that this is the total market cap of the entire crypto asset class. I still think lengthening cycles will prevail. So he's been a big proponent of lengthening cycles. After every halving, the respective bull markets lengthen in number of days. And that is true for what's taking place right now. We are still in a bull market. So if we look at his respective chart here, you see the yellow line here of the trajectory of how the prices will flow. And you can see, you know, we haven't hit a true peak based on the curvature of the chart. Now, this is technical analysis, it's trends, it's math, right? And you're graphing it out. So it's not our emotions or feelings, but you just see historically these peaks have really hit the upper band. And here it hasn't hit the upper band yet. So again, the data suggests this thing is not over. But you know, as I've said many times, this is not guaranteed, of course. There are no certainties when it comes to investing. And we just have to look at the data, the facts and the analytics, and form a thesis and then place our bets from there, right? Because no one can predict the future. And if anyone tells you that This is exactly how it's going to play out and guaranteed. I said many times, please ask them for the winning lottery numbers, next week's winning lottery numbers. So, you know, I can go play the lottery and become a millionaire that way. So guys, we got to be patient, but let's jump into what Mr. Wonderful Kevin O'Leary had to say on the Anthony Pompliano show today. I think it's very insightful, and it's along the lines of what I've been telling you guys, that if I was an accredited investor, I would be buying the tokens and diversifying, which I am, but also investing in the companies like exchanges and different crypto services. Let me play the clip for you.
So I have come to the conclusion on all things digital, the best way to look at it, and I've said this several times, Bitcoin is not a coin, it's software. Ethereum is not a blockchain, it's software. It's all software. HBAR, software. And so what I do is I say to myself, I've seen this movie before. I was an investor in software, you know, engineers 22 years ago at the learning company when we made educational software. So the way I used to do it then is the way I'm doing it now. I'm a very lucky guy. I can make a phone call and it always gets returned. That's the whole Shark Tank thing. And I get all that. But if I want to invest in Polygon, I want to meet the engineering team, which I did in Dubai. I called them up, met them at the team, heard their vision of what they're doing, looked at the economic reality of the outcome, the potential of it. So first is team. I want to meet the team. If I check the box on team, smart guys, good engineers, good strategy, good group, I'm interested. Here's the test, the second test. What economic value are they creating? In the case of Polygon, let's stay on that Polygon for a second. Aggregating transactions to reduce gas fees on ETH is a smart idea. There's a reason you would do that, because you have an economic reason to pursue that. You save money. Transaction fees are less. So I think the potential of that is large. HBAR, okay? Great team, good engineers. What's the economic premise that would keep that growing? Well, Boeing wants a quasi-centralized, decentralized platform. They want the best of both worlds. HBAR can deliver that. Check the box there. Buy into that one too. Look what's going on with, you know, Solana. I mean, they're trying to solve problems a different way too. Speed everything up. Check the box. Who's working on that? Sam Bankman-Fried and his team. Why wouldn't you bet that horse? So it's all about getting positions in all of these, you know, software platforms. That's what they are. They're software platforms. So I say to institutions, you criticize me for investing in Bitcoin. You own a big position in Microsoft. You own a 5% weighting in Yahoo. What is that? That's software. Why don't you do the same thing in Bitcoin? Why don't you do the same thing in Ethereum? Why aren't you in HBAR? Why aren't you in Polygon? Why aren't you in Serum? Why aren't you in Helium? Like, it's all software. And so with that attitude on, it's hard to say I'll only invest in publicly traded software companies. One day these, to me, and I really believe this, one day crypto and all these software platforms are going to be the 12th sector of the S&P. And I'm just taking the bet now that we're on our way there. And I'm taking and staking my bets now. Broad portfolio. You know, no one, Ethereum is my biggest position right now. Bitcoin's had a bit of a correction. I get it. But there's been volatility. But now, to offset that volatility, I own an exchange. So I want to own more exchanges. I look at it, it's all software.
Let's talk about some of the events.
All right. So very interesting statements there from Kevin O'Leary. A couple of things that I want to iron out. He talked about diversifying, that he holds HBAR, Solana, Ethereum. Obviously, he has some Bitcoin, some Polygon, Matic. Now, I have some of those in my portfolio, such as Ethereum, HBAR. I don't have any Matic, and I don't have any of the Solana because, look, I have a good amount of coins and there's only so much capital I have. And I'm not in a position of Kevin O'Leary. I'm not a millionaire, right? And obviously he's double dipping what I've been telling you guys about for a very long time. He's investing in exchanges, not just the tokens, but in companies. Very smart move on his part. And if you're in a position to do that, it certainly makes sense. And I think once I personally take some profits, at the peak of this bull run, I will look to invest in certain crypto companies as well and go through these different funds. So that is certainly on my radar to diversify. Now, some things he talked about where he looks at it as software, which is interesting. I personally have not thought about it that way, but it is. Blockchains are softwares. Now, you have the tokens, and primarily people look at the tokens, right? And they're on this respective blockchains. But he's kind of flipping the model, so to speak. And I think he's doing that because, as he mentioned, he's trying to talk to these institutions and helping them to understand it, bringing it to their world, so to speak. Hey, forget about the token for a second. You're invested in Google and Microsoft and Yahoo and blah, blah, blah. Those are software-driven companies, right? Well, the next layer is blockchains, and those are softwares too. And the coins are what essentially help those blockchains to function. And your access is, instead of having shares, now you could get shares, obviously, in the companies and the blockchain projects, but you can also hold the tokens, which give you, I think, dual benefits, right? Or it gives you another opportunity to make money off of these investments. There's never been anything like this in the history of the world. So I absolutely agree with him, his perspective on diversifying, how he's looking at solutions. You know, he talked about what type of value is being generated from these projects. Are they solving a problem, right? Talk about Boeing and HBAR. And obviously, as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, if you haven't seen my interview with Mance yet, CEO of Hedera Hashgraph, HBAR, please go watch it. They're doing some big things. They're partnered with Google, IBM, Boeing, LG, and many other enterprises. So very bullish statements here from Kevin O'Leary. And he's also, in other segments with Anthony Pompliano, he talked about he would like to invest and possibly start his own crypto mining business. But what he's looking for is regulations around, in certain areas where he wants to go position that Bitcoin mining service, right? Because I'm sure he's going to look for the cheapest electricity and so forth, and also to be using renewable energy. One of the things he's really been vocal about is making sure that the Bitcoin that has been mined that he's investing in and that corporates are investing in is using clean energy. You know, you think of it as blood diamonds, right? There are diamonds being mined in certain areas, which is clean and good. And there's what's called blood diamonds and so forth. If you guys don't understand that, please look it up. So he's looking to make sure, because you can verify on the blockchain where that Bitcoin came from, the Bitcoins that are mined with renewable energy will be much more valuable. Now, will his thesis be correct? We'll have to wait and see. But I think there's some credence to that because you have these corporates who are very ESG focused and they don't want associations with anything that could hurt them from a brand perspective, and they could be called out. So I think he does have some valid points there. And he has his ear to the ground with a lot of these institutions. He's approaching sovereign wealth funds overseas to invest in crypto. So watch Kevin closely, guys. He's making some big moves. And now that he has skin in the game, he's invested in exchanges and the coins. He's going to do whatever he can to pump the market, right? Look, he has an incentive to do that now. And the same thing, if you're a shareholder of a certain company, you want to represent that company well, so the value goes up. This is just simple economics and investments, right? So very bullish statements on his part. All right, let's move ahead. Sources, this is being reported by Blockworks. Fidelity Vet launching crypto fund of funds. The new firm called Dual Worlds comes as a number of emerging crypto-focused asset managers has increased exponentially. Of course, there's money to be made here. You look at the returns that a lot of these crypto funds and hedge funds are making. It pales in comparison to what the traditional financial firms. And I think this was actually reported recently by the Block Crypto, that crypto funds vastly outperformed traditional hedge funds, guys. So this new emerging asset class is driving all sorts of incentives for money and capital to come in. And this is why I keep stressing, be patient. A lot of these things are still being set up. There's still not the full clarity, you know, the regulations that we need, but that is being worked on. And we're just seeing all these legacy guys, whether they were in traditional finance, you know, Goldman Sachs, Morgan Stanley, or they were in tech space in Silicon Valley, they're now jumping into crypto. So the fund will focus on decentralized finance, non-fungible tokens, the metaverse, Web 3.0, and play-to-earn gaming. A former Fidelity Digital Funds executive is launching a crypto fund of funds that would back both venture and hedge funds focus on digital assets, according to three people familiar with the matter. It says here, Michael Zinneman plans to hold a first close on capital for the flagship vehicle of his new Dual Worlds firm in February, sources said. A second close would occur sometime later this year, with the goal of being to raise $50 to $100 million overall. So I am not surprised by this. I think we're going to see more and more of this happening. And one of the things I recently noticed was some of these folks who are already at hedge funds and investment firms are branching off to start their own thing. It's just amazing. I think there was one, Katie Hahn, I think it was, from Andreessen Horowitz, A16Z. She just left to do her own thing. Man, if I was in the position that they were, I would be doing the same thing and going around knocking on doors. Hey, I got this crypto fund. Here's our plan. Give me 10, 15 million, whatever it is. Here's the expected rate of return and the timeline, yada, yada. It's milk and honey out there, guys, like I said in yesterday's video. And if you're personally an entrepreneur and you're looking to start a crypto business, there's no better time. You can certainly go out there and get funding very easily. I can't imagine like just getting like, let's say $20 million to get your project up and running. I think that's super easy. Now, if you're looking for like 50 million above, that's probably a little bit harder, but I mean, the money's out there, guys. All right, moving ahead. Indian Prime Minister calls for the global corporation of cooperation of on cryptocurrency. Now, this news comes in context of what we heard just last week, that they're about to approve Bitcoin ETFs. So a complete 180 from India. You know, they've been bipolar on regulations for years. It's been back and forth. But Narendra Modi likened crypto to supply chain disruptions, inflation, and climate change, saying they can't be tackled by nations in isolation. What have I been saying for years, guys? Even if they put up this, you know, this pushback and this hard stance, and we're going to ban it, it's illegal and blah, 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 they will be forced to bend the knee. Any country or nation that takes an anti-crypto stance will be left behind. Their economy will go to the, it will be trash. It will be in the garbage, guys. Their currency, we know already fiat currencies are not performing well and they're being debased, right? They will even further be debased as a result of not embracing crypto. And, you know, all these countries are also looking to build their CBDC. So that's why when I see a country come out and say, oh, no, we crypto and Bitcoin is the devil and it's evil, blah, 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 and they take these hard stands, it's, you know, they are primed for disruption. Their people are using it because they see a way out and they are scared. And we saw this with some African countries too. If I'm not mistaken, I think Nigeria, some of these countries there, they have really bad inflation. And look, this exists in different parts of the world, in Turkey, Venezuela, Argentina, and so forth. So it's not specific to African countries, but I'm just giving examples. And crypto will really help these countries, I think, help solve a lot of the currency inflation that they've had for years. And this new technology will really help to solve some problems. So speaking virtually at the 2022 World Economic Forum's annual Davos conference, Modi said cryptocurrency is an example of the kind of challenges we are facing as a global family with a changing global order. To fight this, every nation, every global agency needs to have a collective and synchronized action. Likening cryptocurrency to supply chain disruptions, inflation, and climate change, Modi said the kind of technology cryptocurrency is associated with makes decisions taken by one country inadequate to meet the challenges posed by cryptocurrency. We have to have a common thinking. The Indian government has yet to formulate its own regulatory framework for crypto assets and has already decided to study regulatory measures elsewhere and how global standards on cryptocurrencies evolve. The finance ministry has reached out to the Bank of International Settlements to frame its legislation. Of course, better get on board or you will be left behind and you will become irrelevant. You better innovate and adapt to this technology or you will be dead. Look at Blockbuster and their failure to adapt to the internet. Now, if you're a holder, or excuse me, if you're a user of crypto.com, I have some not so good news today. Crypto.com suspends withdrawals following unauthorized activity. Users are required to sign back into their accounts and reset their two-factor authentication. There's not much else on what happened here, but what is the takeaway here? Make sure you keep the majority of your crypto on a hardware wallet. I've said it for years, those of you who follow me, right, that I keep my crypto on a Ledger Nano S and an X, and I don't have to worry. I don't have to, you know, if an exchange gets hacked or whatever it may be, I don't have to worry that I lose all my crypto. So please be sure you're doing that. Now, exchanges have become more sophisticated. Their security have gotten better. Some of them have insurance, but I still would not put all my crypto there. Do I have some crypto on exchanges? Yes. And I've told you guys, because I swing trade, I'm doing different things with it. So I do have some crypto on exchanges, but not all of it, guys. I have my hardware wallet and I recommend you put your majority of your crypto there. Unless you don't need to do anything and you just put it all on the hardware wallet and back up your private keys and make sure all of that stuff is taken care of, guys. So they did post an update here on Twitter saying withdrawal services have been restored. All funds are safe. It will take some time to clear the backlogs. We appreciate your patience. So look, we all have to use exchanges to buy our crypto, but like I said, don't keep all your crypto on there. It's very high risk. All right, look at this. This is very bullish. Crypto jobs on LinkedIn rocketed 395% in 2021. Job postings with the terms like Bitcoin, Ethereum, blockchain, and cryptocurrency grew 395% in the United States. And guess what? It's growing worldwide as well. This is a sign of growth of this emerging asset class. And it's here to stay, guys. And we're seeing a lot of legacy financial people jumping into the crypto market. You know, once again, I always say price is important, but this type of news right here just makes me so bullish because I know all these things will dovetail together and we're going to see huge mass adoption, higher valuations and prices. But patience is so important. This is why I share these news items. We talk a bit about the price, but we have to look at who's building, who's investing, where's capital coming from, where is it going, and so on and so forth. And these macro level trends are so important to understand what's happening in the asset class. So crucially, the crypto industry outpaced the wider tech industry, which also saw remarkable development, also almost doubling its number of job listings. However, at 98% growth, the tech industry dwindles in comparison to crypto jobs, which gained by a whopping 395%. Guys, that's significant. Crypto jobs in specific beat the larger tech industry. And we know how big the tech industry is in Silicon Valley and the Googles and the Facebooks and the LinkedIn and so on and so forth. We've seen that being a big part of the jobs and job creation and so forth for years. But now the tide is slowly changing, my friends. And crypto is where the hot jobs are. You can probably get a lot of money, you know, the salary you're looking for. So, you know, I highly recommend you guys look into this. If your skill sets can be applied to some crypto companies in the market, and if you're a believer in crypto and you're passionate, why not? You know, I made the big move to go to work for OKCoin Crypto Exchange in 2021. I left the job I was at for about 8 years. So it was a big change for me, but I love crypto. I love the technology. I was passionate about it. And I made a big move. And, you know, I encourage many of you to do it. Obviously, do your research, know what you're getting into, but you could certainly, once again, because there's so much capital right now, probably get the salary that you want or higher. So something to think about, my friends. Nevertheless, bullish times are ahead. Patience is the key. Make sure you're looking at the market macro level, and you're also paying attention to all these investments and building and expansions that are happening. These things are important for the future of the market and will lead to higher prices. So guys, what do you think about this news? What do you think about what Mr. Wonderful Kevin O'Leary had to say? Leave your thoughts and comments below. Hit the thumbs up button, share this video, and I'll talk to you all later.